stand, and if you're able, let's give the Lord some praise. Hey, we may be few in number today, but we still serve a big God. Amen. Listen, we have a lot of needs this morning. I can't begin to tell you how many people messaged this morning. A lot are traveling right now, going down to the beach and other places, and then so many are sick. And the McNutt family, I mean, they's about 16 of them, they got children that's sick. So we just want to bless them and lift them up to the Lord this morning. And all of the ones, I see so many different empty pews this morning that our family that's not here, that we miss them when they're not here. We miss them, but just because they're not here, the praise must keep on going on. Amen. Church must keep on going, and we're going to pray for them, and that God touches them and brings them back soon and very soon, that God heals them. You know, God is still a healer. You believe that this morning? God is still the healer. God is still our provider. He's our dearest friend, and I praise God this morning for everything. You know, when I told Sonia this morning, Brother Dustin, I said, the love of the devil, and she said it also. The devil's trying to stop God from doing something today, but we ain't going to allow it, brother. Brother Bill, we're going to keep on praising God through it all. If the music stops, our praise will not. He may be able to stop the internet, but he won't be able to shut our mouths. Hallelujah. We're going to continue to praise God. Continue to sing and just dance and shout and whatever you feel like doing this morning. I pray just get in the Spirit of God and get lost in His presence. Hallelujah. Let the Lord have His way. We get our volunteers this morning. Yeah, y'all want to come help us? Thank you. We need three this morning, I believe. It is the Loaves and Fish Sunday offering also, isn't it? Is that right? All right. All right. So, Brother Steve, Brother Brandon, they'll have our regular offering. And Riley will be doing the Loaves and Fish offering this morning. But if you have a need this morning, would you slip up your hand? If you got more than one, you can raise them both up. But we know that God is able. We know. Sister Sharon, God, the word says that we know that God is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above anything that we can ask or think. Sister Diane, I can think of a lot, but my God is able to do exceedingly more than anything I can even think of. And so COVID has to bow in the name of Jesus Christ. I'm going to go ahead and take authority over that disease. No plague, the Bible says, shall come now our dwelling. I know what churches that are being right now that they're not even able to have service this morning, Brother Stephen. I'm not saying we're more faithful than them or God loves us more, but I'm saying we have got to take authority right now in Jesus' name and believe and confess that God is able to keep that plague away from here. He is able right now in the name of Jesus to keep it away from ourselves, our families, our friends, our loved ones. And God, we give it all to you right now. We're asking you to have your way this morning. Touch every need in the house. Touch every, Lord, request that's on our heart, God, unspoken as well. Touch them, Lord, and move in Jesus' name. Would you bless us this morning, this service, God, as we bless you. Lord, that's what we want to be, a blessing to you, God. And our praise go up and the worship goes up, that the glory will come down. Lord, we thank you and we praise you. God, I pray over this offering right now that you would touch and bless the gift and the giver. The ones who don't have a gift, bless them also, Lord. And we ask it all in the precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And the church said, amen and amen.
To love, healing.
Because